This year, it's called the Alexander South African Composers Award, thanks to a philanthropist who is here tonight and who will be part of the ceremony after the concert. The format is very simple, it's straightforward. We're going to play the five finalists of the concert. And while they deliberate for the final choice, we will listen to two works. The first one is Zixi Shen's Smoke, and Conrad Asman, the winner of last year's competition, his composition was, he had a commission from us as part of his prize. He was our resident composer for the past year in 2023. And tonight we will hear the new composition that he wrote for us. There's just one small detail. When we printed the program last week, we were not sure what the order were, so we put it in alphabetical order. So if you look at the program, just the first two, Owen Dalton's work and Lisa Brill's work, swap around. That's all changed. And then afterwards, we will continue with the ceremony. So I'm afraid it's a bit of a long sit. We've sit through the five works, and then the judges leave, and then the two more showcase works, and then we'll have the ceremony afterwards. Congratulations that you're all here tonight, and thank you for being here. It's for us a fantastic occasion, and we're very pleased that we have such a good and big audience. Thank you very much.
Hello everybody. Liebe Musikfreunde, Molweni. Music is a language everybody understands, and musical creativity is a source of inspiration to all of us. Therefore, it is a wonderful initiative of the Junge Norddeutsche Philharmonie Foundation to provide young talents with opportunities and to raise their profile with the AIMA, the Alexander International Music Award. I would like to thank everybody involved and all representatives of the Junge Norddeutsche Philharmonie for this outstanding work. This competition truly connects people. Musicians from Germany join musicians from the Cape Town Philharmonic Orchestra to practice and to perform in joint premieres. This is a wonderful opportunity for composers and musicians alike. Artists are not only virtuosos in their field, but their work also has an influence on political and social conditions of their time. This was the case with Beethoven, with modern musicians like Keith Richards, or the great Miriam Makeba from South Africa. They initiated discussions or addressed social changes with their music. We are excited to see what today's young generation has to offer, to see their suggestions that create meaning or, in the best sense of the word, that cause creative unrest. I therefore wish the composers a lot of inspirations for the future. I wish the musicians the ability to inspire, and I wish us listeners the capability to recognize true talent. All the best, and as we say in South Africa, halala. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
I suppose we can go ahead without closing the doors. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, once again. It's my pleasure as CEO and Artistic Director of the Cape Town Philharmonic Orchestra to welcome everybody on stage again and to introduce to you to our convener of the competition, which is a very important and very difficult task. That's Antoni Skonken. And the chairman of the voting panel, Hendrik Hofmeyr, next to me. And of course, our guest of honor and our sponsor and a visionary, Alexander Valentin. Alexander, I know you can't wait to say something to us. It's all
Thank
yours.
You
well, good evening. I was waiting all year, all evening long to raise the, to have a word. Anyway, being a German citizen, I have a long-standing love affair with Cape Town and with South Africa. For 30 years, I happily lived and worked here and enjoyed some of the most exceptional concerts with the Cape Town Orchestra. Therefore, I made the decision that I would love to give back to this wonderful country that lives in my heart and in my history. My love for music comes from my beloved mother, Elsa. In our family, we never had an established music tradition or even the knowledge about classical music. And after the premature death of my father, my mother would drag me at the age of 11 into concerts and operas. She made me learn how to play the piano, and as an autodidact herself, she taught me how to love classical music. Without her, I would not stand here today. As always in later life, as always, it is in later life only that we learn what is most important for us. I can say from my own experience that access to classical music is one of the most crucial things to young people, that they can decide for themselves if they tolerate it, if they love it, or if they make their career out of it. This is also the reason why I will sponsor the Cape Town, the CPYO, with a future focus on black communities. Today, some of the world's most famous instrumental soloists come out of Asia, where Philharmonic Orchestra is neither part of their heritage nor of their tradition. Could this not also happen in Africa? And now I'm changing my speech because of the special reason. The contest is now named the Alexander, which is very nice. I lost my very beloved good son by the name of Alexander about 6 weeks ago. And in the future, I would like to dedicate, rest in peace. Thank you.
Thank you very much for that, Alexander, and really that was extremely moving, and we are all hugely indebted to you. I think it wouldn't be amiss for us to just stand for 10 seconds to commemorate the memory of Alexander, after whom this competition will be named. Thank you very much. We are hugely indebted to Alexander, and we have a long list of other people that we need to thank as well. I think, first of all, Jeremy Silver, our marvelous conductor, who did an incredible job. I think few people in this audience know what it takes to conduct seven works, of which I think five were never conducted before. And of course, all seven entirely new to him. He made it sound like he's been doing them all his life. So to him and to the orchestra, a huge bravo and a huge thank you. I'm sure you'll all agree that we had a lovely and very exciting evening with wonderful sounds, wonderful personalities emerging in the different works. And I would now like very much to give a certificate to each of the finalists to acknowledge their contribution. So, in alphabetical order, Lisa Brill. Owen Dalton. Michaela Lopesha. Chesney Palmer. And Kirvin Pietras. Right, and we come to the moment everyone has been waiting for. Sorry to have kept you waiting for so long, but I think the lengthy discussion we had goes to show also how close these five finalists were. And it took quite a lot of sifting for us to arrive at a final result with which we could all be happy. So, I think quite independent of who won the three prizes, I think all five candidates really did extremely well and can really hold their heads high after tonight. So. One last thing just before I hand over the prize, I'm just going to keep you on the edges of your seats for one moment longer. I think there are two people that we really also need to thank just in terms of the enormous amount of organization that went into this. One is Shirley Geller and the other is Antoni. And here we go. Third prize of 5,000 Rand goes to Kirvin Pietras. The second prize of 10,000 Rand goes to Owen Dalton. And the first prize of 50,000 Rand goes to Lisa Brill. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Without you, all this would of course not have been possible. So we hope to see you here again next year, and safe trip home.